Hello, I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students. And today is day number 25 for the A-plus curriculum, also known as the Network Control Operator class. Now, normally in these lessons, we're going over with the videos and we're learning about hardware and taking apart computers. There will be a mini lesson this week where I'll be upgrading a Acer Chromebook 15's hard drive from the 16 gigabyte SSD to a 32. So I'll show you how to do that. But in this particular video, I'm going to be going over two topics. One topic is using Freedompop. Freedompop gives you a phone, so I bought this one for $40. And then it comes with a free service. So I'm going to go over exactly what Freedompop is, how to find it, and then how to downgrade your service so that it's the free basic service. And then I'll show you some details on that as well. The other topic that we have is video streaming sites. Now we're all very familiar with YouTube and maybe one or two other video sites. But the thing is, many times a user, a computer user, gets in a rut and a habit of going to the same channels, the same types of videos, and watch those types of content over and over again. But what I'm going to do now is show over 40 different video streaming sites from a wide range of old TV shows, documentaries, science programs, everything else under the sun, sports, if you like sports. So we're going to discover over 40 plus video streaming sites, and each of those sites have literally millions of hours of content for you to browse over, and hopefully you'll find something that you like. Well, let's get started with the lesson. First off, let's go ahead and start with Freedompop. What is Freedompop? Freedompop is a wireless internet and mobile virtual network operator. It's based in Los Angeles, California, and it started back in 2011. The company provides free IP mobile services, including free data, text, and voice over internet protocol, or VoIP. And it sells mobile phones, tablets, and broadband devices for use with their services. They also offer premium services for better voice quality and larger data plans. So here's a short chart here, and they go over with the Sprint, 3NF, so AT&T. And here's the technology they use. Now, if you want to go with the free plan, and they go over the network of Sprint, it's 500 megs a month. But there's others, if it depends on your area, that's only 200 megs a month. And here's the location. So if you're in the US, you go with Sprint. If you're in the UK, you go with 3. And here's other parts of the US. Then we have voice communications. They have cellular voice, which is higher quality, and that would come with the premium services. They also have the voice over internet protocol, which is free, and there's no roaming on any of those. And so question comes up, they say, well, how do you like Freedompop? Well, the answer is, I do like Freedompop. I've been using it for a few years now, haven't been charged anything except for the initial startup. How much was the initial startup? Well, it was $40 to buy the phone. And I bought the phone, and it is a nice Motorola phone, newer Android phone. And it works great with my Android apps and my games. I make phone calls with it using just the free services. So that's all over voice over internet protocol. And I have the free 500 megs per month plan. Now, when you go with the free plan, you want to go into your phone, go into your settings, and then just click on data from there. And then you'll notice you'll have a chart just limit your data to whatever your plan is. So if you have the premium 1 gig or 2 gig or 5 gig, whatever plan that you're going with, just make sure that you limit your phone so that it will stop downloading data over the cellular data, that is, once it reaches a certain threshold. Now, going on with Freedompop's quality, some have said that the voice over internet protocol quality, or the VoIP voice quality, is poor. And that really depends on your area that you're in. I'm here in Central California, and it's been okay. I've been happy with it. Yes, it can be better. So I would probably give it 7 stars out of 10. Now, others in Fresno, which is also Central Valley, not too far from me, have given it fewer stars than that. They said, oh, it was just too poor of a quality, and they were used to higher quality from the cellular voice. They didn't want to pay the premium, which is less than $20 a month, so they went with a different service provider altogether. Others have also said that there's an echo, that they could hear an echo over the VoIP, so that they would say something and then they would hear their voice coming back after a few seconds, and that is a problem with VoIP. I have not experienced that problem on my particular phones, but others have experienced that. So there's pros and cons. So is it worth it? Well, for a free service, and if you don't make very many calls, which I don't make very many calls per month, I just use it when I'm out and about on town and I need to call home and see, hey, what do you guys need? And then the guys will tell me, oh yeah, we need a bag of chips or whatever they want for dinner. I'll buy those things at the store, I come back. That's my extent of using it. I just, not very much. So I'm perfect for the free plan. Others use their cell phones all day long. And then they would be, of course, running out of the data for the cellular data, maybe running out of the minutes and all that too. So it just really depends on how you use your phone. Let's say you want it as a good second phone. There you go. Have it as a second phone, something to pair up with your primary phone. Maybe you have a primary phone through Verizon or AT&T. You want a second phone just to hang around with and use it for something. It's free, right? The phone itself, usually they run between $20 and $40 to buy the newer Android phone. Yes, they're not the newest, they're not 2017. Mine was about a year old, which was totally acceptable for me. And I've been using it every day. I also bought more for my boys. I have three boys, and one of them is in high school, and he uses it every day, and he's happy with it. It has not gone over any type of data threshold or minutes threshold for voice. So, and he says he's happy with it. He makes his calls with it, and he's happy with it, so I'm happy with it. I bought another one for my wife, and she's happy with hers too. So there you go. It's all up to you on finding it, though. It's at freedompop.com. And now we're going to talk about how to downgrade. Let's say that you didn't want the premium service, that you were happy with just the free voice over internet protocol service. So how do you downgrade to the free plan? Because when you first get it, you can get it one of two ways. You can get it with a way that it charges $20 a month, and they call this the premium plan, but the first month is free, so you get the phone for it, you pay $40 for the phone, and that's it. And then you get 1 month free premium voice and data, and then all, like I said, it's $20. Let's say you want to downgrade, so you'd go in and then you downgrade that to the free plan by following the steps that we're going to go over here in a few minutes. The other way that I've actually seen many advertisements out there from Freedompop, so you saw one today, you buy the phone for $20. They have a special going on right now. And I was surprised. Oh, wow, that's pretty good. You get a phone for $20, and then it's free service forever. And they were offering that service too. Again, it's limited to either 500 megs or 1 gig per month, but hey, it's free. And you don't even have to downgrade it. It's already free and given to you. And then, of course, you have the minutes along with that too, given free with the phone. Alrighty, but let's say that you did buy the phone and you have the premium service today and you want to downgrade to the free plan. Let's see how to do that. So, as a Freedompop user, you can change your data plan or services at any time. So, just remember that. Keep that in mind. They offer many, many different little services depending on your particular niche or what you need. And I think it's over 20 different services that I looked last time I saw there. You can manage your current data plan and voice plan straight from your Freedompop account. So now, let's just stop right there. I just said Freedompop account. Yes, when you buy your phone, you want to go to freedompop.com and make sure that you acquire a free Freedompop account. And that's with usually an email address and a password of your choosing. You create the password. This is very important because later in life, let's say months down the road, you want to change the plan, the data plan. Maybe you want to go and try out the data plan that's premium or one of the other plans that they have. You have to use your Freedompop account to do this. And that again will be an email address and a unique password for you. If you are on a paid plan and wish to downgrade to a free one, just select the details and plan management and then tap the link at the bottom, which says something like confirm the downgrade. Be sure to do the same for both your voice and data plans if you wish to avoid any monthly charges. Now, again, that's if you already have a premium plan and you want to go down to bare nothing, that is a free plan like I have, which still allows for the 500 to 1 gig, depending on what plan that you have, because there's two different free plans, 500 megs or 1 gig per month, and then free either 200 or 500 minutes per month. Again, they offer different plans at different times of the year, which are free. And once you get locked into that free one, you always will receive that same amount every month for free. You can also manage your current add-on services by logging into your Freedompop account at www.freedompop.com. If you wish to disable any value-added service, just select View Details of the service you wish to edit or downgrade and tap the link at the bottom. Be sure to confirm your cancellation, because guess what? If you don't confirm the cancellation, it doesn't stick. The cancellation doesn't stick. You actually have to click that one button at the end of the whole procedure. It says, are you sure you wish to cancel your premium services? And you say yes, and yes again. Now, you may also wish to call them. Let's say that you've forgotten your Freedompop account information altogether. You say, well, I don't know which email account I used, and who knows what password I used. Then you can always call them at 855-703-5785, and the number is on the screen. So let's just look. I took some screenshots of mine here. So you would log into your Freedompop account, and then you'd click on this button here that says My Account, and it comes up. It shows how many billing cycles you have left and your talk limits. Now, right when I went in to go for the free plan on that day, now it's not every day, but certain days of the year, on that particular day, they said, oh, we have a free plan with free unlimited talk minutes. Just, wow, I was like shocked. I go, yes, I want that. So there you go. I took that, and I can use unlimited phone minutes or talk as much as I want and never be charged for the hours and hours that I use the phone. Next is text. What came with it was unlimited messages or text messages. I don't really use text messages. A lot of my friends, they use it, and I'll get a text from them and I'll reply to them maybe in a few days. Like I said, I really don't use text messages that often. And then data. They were giving 1 gig of data free a month. So I said, yeah, let me have it, because that's a good deal. And you can see there, I used some of that and I still have 838 megs left. This is the phone that I bought for the $40. It was a Motorola E, second generation, 4G. And I've had it now for a number of years. I mean, it's not just 1 year. I've had it for longer than a year. And so, like I said, this phone is an older phone today, but if you go there, they have newer models than this probably. Okay, now another thing you'd probably notice over here, you say, well, who's all these people's names and what's happening here? It says get more megabytes from your friends. So your current friend data pool is 5.9 gigs. So I have 6 gigs of free data that I haven't even tapped into yet on this account or on this phone. And anytime that a friend puts in my username, basically it's added to my friend network at Freedompop, and then their name comes up here and it gives me another 50 megs. So it doesn't sound like very much per person, but like I said, I have thousands of students per year, and that's how I get 6 gigs per for all of these free services here. Let's keep on going down now and see what else. So if you click on my account, you get the overview, which is what we've been looking at. And you also have plans, international. Now let's say you call Mexico, or you call Japan. My wife uses it to call Japan. If you click here, and you can actually look at the international plans and sign up for a really good international plan, and I'll be allowed to make many, many calls and many hours of conversations there to around the world. Usage, of course, that's going to show you how much you've used. And then devices. You can have more than one device on your Freedompop account. So they sell more than just phones at the freedompop.com site. They have Wi-Fi routers, or stuff like that, like a Wi-Fi hotspot, I should say. This Wi-Fi hotspot, basically, it's really small. It's smaller than a cell phone. It's actually very, very tiny. You just put it in your pocket, turn it on, and then it connects to the 4G network in your area. And then you have a mobile hotspot wherever you go. And they do have that as free as well. You just buy the device and they have free plans. So that could be one of your devices. I did go for one of those as well. And it's great. So when you're in a pinch and you don't have internet anywhere else, you can use that. And you have account settings. Account settings, you'd go in there and just make sure that you got your right address and the right email, because some people change their email every once in a while, like I do. I do change my emails. And you can update your account settings that way. And then, of course, the phone number. One of the good things that I haven't spoken about with Freedompop is that you can port your phone number from your old device or your old service that you had. Let's say that you were with AT&T or Verizon, and then you said, well, I like that phone number. I had a special phone number with them. I want to keep that phone number. Guess what? Freedompop does allow you to actually bring over that phone number. And here it is. It's called phone number. And to do that, it's not free, obviously, because usually Verizon charges to give out that phone number, and also AT&T. All right, let's say that we clicked on services. What would you see? You would see this right here on mine. It says, you are currently not signed into any services yet. Alrighty, and if you look here, Yeah, because I signed into the unlimited talk minutes and unlimited messages and 1 gig per month for free. So I didn't need any of these other premium services yet. But let's say that I start doing some traveling and I wanted to add services. Then here we go. Freedompop Premium Plus. This is access our most popular services that maximizes your Freedompop value. Okay, basically that's the Freedompop Premium Plus is going over, and it's more data, basically, and that's $7.99 a month. You just click on activate or view details, and you could show you all the details that go along with that service. Again, $7.99 a month, that's not too bad. Then you have Freedompop Premium Voice. Now this will go over with cellular voice. So before it was VoIP, remember, that's all you had for the free service. But as soon as you go with the premium service, you drop off the VoIP, no more echoing and all that, and you go over with the high quality voice there. And look at that, it's only $3.99 a month, which is great. Then you have Freedompop ad blocking. Now, just to let you know, I haven't seen any ads on my phone. It was like when I turn on my phone, it's not like it says, hello, here's an ad for you or anything like that. I haven't seen an ad, so I'm not sure exactly what ads they're blocking, because I haven't seen an ad. But if you wanted that, it's only $1.99 a month, so that you're never annoyed by any type of an ad. And that is my spiel on Freedompop. We're now going to go over to a different topic here in a second. If you have any comments on Freedompop, maybe you've had a bad experience with Freedompop and you want to do a shout out, yes, go ahead and do a shout out and comment on the video down below and give us your feedback on your negative experience. Please do not down the video just because you don't like Freedompop. This is not a Freedompop ad at all. I'm just saying that I use Freedompop. Some of my students did not like Freedompop, so I'm on your side. Some people didn't like it. They said the voice quality was simply not acceptable for them, and they were unhappy for one reason or another. So there you go. So please thumbs up the video. And then give me your comment, and if you have a question or other comment about Freedompop, make sure you put it down there and we'll try to help you. Because this is what it's all about, right? We try to help each other here. Next topic. We're now going to be talking about video streaming sites. I'm going to start off with YouTube. Now, if you remember last week, I had a quick little video where I had YouTube problems, and that was because I had two YouTube accounts with the same email address and the same name. Everything was identical, and it seemed as though the AdSense, or for me to receive revenue, was linked onto the channel or onto my account that has absolutely no videos. And so everything said zero on it. And then the video site that had all of my videos was not connected to my AdSense. And so there was a problem there. That has since been corrected. And so we're back to business here, which is wonderful stuff. So great, that YouTube problem was resolved. And actually someone from YouTube actually contacted me and worked out the problem there. So let's go over ahead to the next topic of video streaming sites. We'll start off with YouTube here. YouTube has many great channels for every topic and show genre, from television shows from the 40s, 50s, 60s to current and up-to-date documentary channels and everything else you can even think of. And we're going to look at some channels here at YouTube that I really have found interesting. One of them is called Public Domain Television. Now here we are, it's easy to find. Just go do a YouTube search for Public Domain TV, and he has literally thousands of videos here, and he's uploading new ones all the time. Like these were just a few hours ago, and It's all the shows from the 50s and the 60s. It's great stuff. There's another channel very similar to this one. It's called Stump the Stars. So if you like a particular program, you can also just key in the name of the television program that you liked back in the 50s or even the 40s. They have 40 shows too. And you'll be sure to find it. They do also, you can also find stuff from earlier stuff too, like the 70s and 80s, 90s. And I'm sure there's stuff even after 2000. Okay, and if you go there, make sure you do subscribe. He's already got 58 subscribers, and he just started the channel here not too long ago. Let's go ahead and see some of the playlists that he has here. Here you got, the old Price is Right. I could love watching that. You Bet Your Life, I've watched a few of those. And then we have, Studio One. This is really big here. You get all the really good actors from the 60s, and they showcase them there in Studio One. So if you haven't seen Studio One before, be sure to check that one out. You have the Andy Griffith Show, and again, he just started uploading these videos here just not too long ago, and he's already got 11 Andy Griffith shows. Lights Out, if you like things like Twilight Zone, which I do, you'll love Lights Out. There's also Tales of Tomorrow, which is a little on the creepy side too. So if you like stuff like that, there you go. He's got the new Three Stooges cartoons and then Christmas cartoons and 11 more. So if you click here, it comes up and now you see, Popeye cartoons and the Dick Tracy and Alfred Hitchcock Presents. Now you can find all of the full episodes already on other channels, but he has two videos here and maybe no one else has those videos. If you like stuff like Twilight Zone and Alfred Hitchcock Presents, then you're going to love The Veil, which I've watched all of those. He has that. One Step Beyond is another good one. That is, you gotta watch for the lights out at night. It's just wonderful viewing pleasure. So, that again is the public domain TV. Make sure that you subscribe. And once you do, make sure you tell them that Selma Teacher 7 sent you. Another great channel out there that has many videos is Curious Droid. Now, Curious Droid is a little bit like documentary videos. However, instead of being the hour-long traditional videos that you're used to seeing, these are short. They're only about between 5 and 15 minutes long. And they're great. They have so many good topics there. And like right in this one right here, nuclear powered planes, trains, and automobiles. He goes into the history of when Russia actually had a nuclear powered plane in the air, and they actually flew it. And so you get to see some of the history there. Here's another good one that I just watched. It's called The Biggest Rocket Ever Designed, the Sea Dragon. Just a massive rocket. Of course, it's launched from the ocean, but it dwarfs the Saturn V, if you can believe it. It's an amazing rocket there. The payload is terrific. But anyway, let's go over and see some of the things that he has. So I usually like to click on videos, and then you get to see some of his videos that he's got here. Here's another good one. Here says, what if Apollo had crashed on the moon? I mean, really, what if that had happened? Of course, it was a possibility, yes. And he goes in to all the history and all that. Here's another. How did the Apollo flight computers get men to the moon? And it's amazing. He goes into the design of the computer and everything else and what it did. Another question here is, what if time did not exist? Hey, another one that makes you think, right? So he has a lot of videos here, and you just gotta check them out. And when you go there, make sure you leave a comment saying, hey, Selma Teacher 7 sent me. And make sure you do subscribe to his channel. Let's move right along now. YouTube has a huge following in viewership, but YouTube is not the only fish in the sea. Of course, there is HBO, Netflix, ESPN, and Hulu. But have you visited Twitch.com, Vimeo.com, Medicaf.com, or Voa.com lately? So all we want to do is we want to look at some of these others, such as the ones I mentioned here, plus 40 others, and see what they offer for the viewer. We're here at Twitch.com now. So this is Twitch, and it's a lot of different videos here. I went there and I was just shocked by just the amazing content they have. It's very similar to YouTube, but they go over games. So people playing the games, and they have millions of people basically watching people play the games. Now, it's not just people playing the games. There's talk, there's conversation going on. So there's a lot of interaction there, and people love that. And so actually it was discovered that more people watch these types of videos than anything else. So this is number one, actually. So try out twitch.com and just go around and see what you like. Next one on my list is VimeoMed. Now, Vimeo actually is it's a premium site here. It has videos that you can watch. There's TV programming, there's movies, and everything else. Now, you can say join now. It's free for the basic plan, and that's 500 megs a week. And what you go is it's unlimited bandwidth, so it's wonderful high definition movies, television, that type of thing, up to 500 megs a week free. And if you really like the program and you want to go, hey, I think I like this, you could go and say, well, I want to go for maybe the $5, $17, or even $50 a month deal there. And you can see how you can increase your hours of viewing and all that. But basically, this is wonderful, high definition TV programming, channels, everything's there. And it's all ad-free, so you have no commercials whatsoever. So you gotta try it out. Just try out to join the free one there at Vimeo.com and see what you can find. And our next one that we're gonna visit is Medicaf. Now, Medicaf.com is here, and basically they have a number of short videos, but usually they're less than a minute long. Here's one, and let's go over here. Boom, crash. Ooh, crash into a classic car there. How sad. So that's Medicaf.com. A bunch of millions of short videos, most of them being less than a minute long. Now we're going to continue on with more streaming site options. Now, there's actually over 40 additional streaming sites that I have listed here. It's crazy. But we're going to go over all of them here. First off is ABC.com. ABC, like NBC, now offers a wide range of streaming videos, including full episodes of the most popular TV shows. So let me just stop there for a second. YouTube, we found classic TV, right, at public domain TV and all that. So it was great stuff for 40 years ago or 50 years ago, 70 years ago TV. If you want modern TV, there you go. ABC.com, full-length episodes, just like watching on a regular TV. Then you have this site. This is the Archaeology Channel.com, and it offers hours of free streaming video based on culture, humans, and archaeology. Archive.org, National Archive, streams footage of past events and old documentaries. Ooh, I think I could spend some time there, including space documentaries from the 70s. Oh, I could just eat that up for years. So yes, this is a good one here. You can mark that up there. I like it. Next is BigContact.com. Big Contact, allows users to create their own channels and offers several professional streaming channels to anyone to watch. Interesting. Next is blinkdex.com, boasting over 32 million hours of video footage. Aye, 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 but you can't blink during that time, huh? Next is break.com. This video website is marked towards men and has a list of daily video pics on their homepage. The videos are outrageous, funny, and short. I guess that's what men want. Outrageous and funny and short videos, because our attention span is short. That's called break.com. Next is broadbandsports.com. Hey, are you a big sports fan? I know some of my students out there love sports because I see your jackets. Sports videos on all types can be found on Broadband Sports, including recaps, highlights, athletic videos, and professional sports videos. Next is Clip Shack. This website features short clips, recaps, and small videos of random content. Reminds me a lot of like Flicky.com or Flixy.com. Next we have CollegeHumor.com. Their version of videos focuses mainly on the humorous end and focuses towards the college demographic. So it's true. I do watch some of the videos at CollegeHumor.com. And there's a lot of great shows there. And it's not just short videos or short programs. They do have some programs that are 15 minutes and longer. Comcast Xfinity. Comcast Fancast has been renamed to Comcast Xfinity Videos. This shows a variety of free TV shows along with much content you have to be a subscriber to watch. So if you already have Comcast, don't miss out on that. So there you go. Next is Crackle.com. This is one of the ones I do go off to as well. It's called Crackle.com. It's more of an indie offbeat TV shows and movie website. You can watch web shows and other shows that you can't watch on normal TV. I love Crackle.com because you can also get a lot of programming from the 70s and 80s. That you can't find at ABC or NBC any longer, but it's found at Crackle.com. One good example would be All in the Family or all the others there. Next one is Current.com. This website, it has a wide array of modern video content and is very similar to YouTube. So there you go, another YouTube type of channel called Current. Next is DailyMotion.com. Now in the past I have watched Daily Motion because there were some TV programs that I just simply didn't have access to, and they were only found at Daily Motion, which was awesome. So Daily Motion is similar to Current TV. It offers a wide range of random video content, and I'm going to specify a little bit higher there. You can find Current TV programs that were maybe aired last week, last month, and you missed the show, you go, oh no, I missed this program, or whatever it was, go to Daily Motion, and guess what? You just might find it there. Next is DevilDucky.com. This website features favorite videos grabbed from many different sources and aggregated together. The website contains small videos, TV shows, there you go, movie trailers, news recaps, fan videos, and even more. So DevilDucky.com is another one that you might want to go to find those TV programs that you just can't find anywhere else. Next is Documentary Storm, a website dedicated to free, full-length documentaries from all over the internet. All right, now, just to let you know, I have gone to this site there. Documentary Storm is great. They have a great format, and you can actually go in and very easily find the types of documentaries, like if you like astronomy or if you like biology or whatever science that you love. History is another big one there. Just type in those words and find many, many documentaries right up your alley. Next is lfilm.com, a standard video streaming website Gotta try that one out there. Next is Museum TV or Museum.tv. DocuFest is an online video archive website with access to theater reenactments, historic video and radio streams, and interviews. So there you go. NBC.com. NBC now streams dozens of their episodes for free. Just, I might want to let you know, there is a time limit. So let's say if you missed a program and I missed the program 2 years ago. Well, guess what? You're going to have to find it from one of these other channels, such as devilducky.com or current.com, one of these others. This is usually only the last few months at NBC. If you go back too many years, you won't be able to find your episode that you missed. Next is newgrounds.com, an awesome and high-end website featuring user-submitted satire, animation, and humor videos. Now, many of my videos are under this category, satire. That was my earlier videos. And believe it or not, one of my biggest revenueing videos is complete satire. And I put it out, I think it was like 2012, 2013, somewhere like then. And it just hits still every day. So that's a good one there. Next is openvideo.org. This website is a shared digital video collection and has lecture, documentary, educational, and historical videos, as well as others, for free streaming. So there you go. Next is rmedia.org. rmedia lacks a professional site, but has dozens of channels to search. There you go. Next is fanfare.com. Fanfare is a unique video sharing website, as it is meant to be used with an iPhone and makes uploading, sharing, and viewing mobile videos easier than ever. Next is revere.com. You'll find a wide variety of, or wide array of content on Revere. Most of it is high quality and serious. Their video base includes interviews, skits, product reviews, movie reviews, animations, and tutorials. Next is 7load.com. 7load is a sleek, professional-looking video streaming website with categories such as music, do-it-yourself, arts, and politics. Speedy TV. User-uploaded streaming videos and movies, as well as sorted videos from other locations. Stars Play. Stars Play is offered from Verizon and allows users to stream hundreds of blockbuster movies and the Stars TV channel for around $10 per month. Next is Tikam.com. Tikam is a twist on the modern video streaming site. You can browse hundreds of live streaming video feeds and interact with other viewers via a chat box. Very interesting there. Have not tried that one out. Streetfire.net. This website has thousands of videos, most of them dealing with cars in some way. Makes sense. That's why they call it Street Fire. Next is stupidvideos.com. As the name of the website suggests, don't expect to find enlightening videos here. However, if you're looking for some good laughs, there is no better than stupidvideos.com. Okay, and I love their name there. Thatvideosite.com. Are you kidding me? This website pulls the most popular videos from a wide range of websites and lists them all on a homepage for your viewing pleasure. Next is the NewsHour. The PBS NewsHour .miss. And don't miss an important news speak coverage or documentary. The NewsHour has regular updates of free streaming news coverage. So there you go, as the suggestion here. If you ever miss any news, just go here to the NewsHour. And where is that at? That is found at pbs.org newshour. So that's where it's found there. You can pause it there if you need to write it down. Or next is Truvio. Truvio streams content from dozens of different sites, including Hulu, Lifetime, and GQ. TV Duck provides links to other internet sources, streaming movies, and TV shows. So there you go, TV Duck. Next is Ustream.tv. Ustream TV is another live streaming website, allowing users to chat with each other while watching a particular or participating in live video streams. Okay, I think I know what goes along there. Next is VideoBomb.com. The website is a basic, bland video streaming site with random videos. Makes you want to go there. I love bland videos. Okay. VideoShift.com. VideoShift works very similar to the popular website Dig. Users add videos and other users shift through them, pushing the good ones to the top while the poor ones fall to the bottom. Interesting. Very interesting. Next is viz.myspace.com, and MySpace TV offers a wide array of video content, including personal videos, vlogs, and TV recaps. Wow, that is a lot of video content to go over. So I'm sure you'll be able to find something that tickles your fancy. Well, thank you very much for watching the video. For the class, we're going to now be going into lab and working with our Windows laptops, some of the desktops that are there in the back, and also some of the Chromebooks for another group. And as always, please rate, subscribe, and comment to my channel. Alrighty, thank you again, bye-bye.